children, today I am going to explain you about the magnetic resonance imaging. This was discovered by Felix Bloch and Edward Purcell in 1946 and they got Nobel Prize in 1952. MRI scan was utilized in the medical purpose by Raymond Damadian first time. This differs from X-ray imaging and CT scanner by not using ionization radiation. This is a non-invasive procedure and also not harmful. Whereas in X-ray imaging and CT scanner, the ionizing radiation is used, so they are harmful than the MRI scanner. This MRI works by using magnetic field, radio waves and computer. This magnetic field is created by MRI scanner by having a giant circular magnetic tube. This magnetic tube possesses a movable table inside that which can be taken into the magnetic tube. Where this magnetic field was created, and this field creates a magnetic resonance of protons. This proton gives the different densities of images. Those images are processed by computer and gives pictures or images. These images are also called as tomographs. They are thin slices of the body or body parts or organs. This MRI works on the principle of nuclear magnetic resonance. This was created by hydrogen nuclei that we will discuss in the procedure. Our body possesses 75% of water, which possesses numerous water molecules, and each hydrogen atom possesses two nuclei. Or protons. This works like the tiny magnets. When there is no magnetic field, these protons move irregularly, and the energy, the field created by one of the protons by another will become neutralized. When the body is taken into the magnetic field, what will happen? The proton molecules align. So they are arranged on a straight line and in the direction of magnetic field. Whenever we apply the second radio frequency or turn it on for a brief period, what will happen? These protons absorb energy from the radio waves and gets aligned. This is given for a brief period. After some time, we will turn off or switch off this radio frequency. What will happen then? The received energy will be emitted by these protons. It will be captured as an image. So that excited energy state too, they will turn into the equilibrium state, or after that they will become a relaxed state. Due to this, what will happen? The energy released in different wavelengths, those are captured as images and turned into the tomographs. These tomographs can detect very tiny changes in our body. For better resolutions, agents also used, those are called as gadolinium. What are the applications of magnetic resonance imaging? These are identifying abnormalities. These abnormalities can be detected based on the different wavelengths or based on the different quanta of energy emitted by different tissues. Normal tissue and pathological tissue can differ by observing the quanta of energy or wavelengths. Okay, this MRI can be used to identify tumors, tiny fractures in the body and aneurysms. This is called as ballooning of blood vessels. That is a very rupturing of blood vessels can be identified. Examining the brain, spinal cord, skeletal, chest, lungs, abdomen is also done by this MRI. Okay, then I'll discuss about the ECG and EEG in the next classes. Thank you.